I did not heed the plainest of warnings, nor indeed the glimmer of morning. In steam engine smoke and chimney ash appeared an apparition. On his head a stovepipe hat, in his teeth an exploding cigar, on his shoes spats to keep the cack off. Thus I beheld the apparition. Green flesh on the turn, the smell was strong, though his scent was once so refined. He put a finger and thumb in a hole in his skull and gave me a piece of his mind. And he carried a cane, silver-tipped, hard and heavy, to punish those who knew not their place. Wise to the ways of the lower orders, the liberties and the piss they take. You had your chance, little man. You had all the breaks a poor boy can. But you threw the natural order out of whack. Thus quoth the apparition. And alack, alack, I must take it back, the power with which I entrusted you. Alas, alas, it has come to pass that I should never have trusted you. In a world so full, it is your own fault if you can't find something to eat. And with tacks and twine and an old seat cover, you can make some shoes for your feet. And don't raise a person above their station if you don't want the trains to be laid. Such was the wisdom passed down by his mother, along with the keys to the estate. His tailcoat claw, his club's cummerbund, the tie of his education. An echoey voice, a salt stick gaze, behold an apparition. An echoey voice, a salt stick gaze, behold an apparition.